Midlife movers. Can you see my squashed tomatoes and stew? I know some of you like looking at my little bits and pieces. I don't know if anyone would recognise that. Right. So this makes sense. Mike and I did an impromptu recce to Brighton today because we dropped Betsy off at the airport with Finn for her holiday to Cyprus about 10:30. So we got to Brighton for sort of about 11:30, I think. So what I've been trying to do is download this bleeding video so you can watch it on Facebook and YouTube. But it's actually about 38. It's a record-breaking documentary. It's about 38 minutes long, which some of you are going to love, especially if you're recuperating or you're on your own, or you just think, oh God, there's that mad woman doing her stuff again. So to make sense of what I'm going to do, because it's so long, I've got to put it in parts. So you're probably going to get several bits and pieces on the WhatsApp group. Delete, delete, delete if you don't need it. But I'm going to try and post it in order so it makes sense. Right. And rest assured, it was a brilliant day. I've just had Czech Republic steak with a reduced beef and red wine sauce with oven baked onions and roast potatoes. That will make more sense to you if you watch the video. I need to tell you I've got my facts right. I wasn't bad with my history. The Lido was built around 1937 to 1938, and it is Art Deco, and that's very apparent. And when I say to you about when we go out past through sort of past Brighton and you drive for a minute, and it's not barren, but it's very green. It's very true of the seaside towns. They were very Victorian. They were built up then for so many reasons. You know, family time was becoming very apparent. So Sundays were spent at the seaside, and sea air was also very good for people. So it's just really interesting. I just get really involved in stuff like that. So you've got videos coming up in patches about or to do with our recce to Brighton, and probably a lot of old nonsense that you didn't need to know. I also need to tell you, we did manage to get back from the rural class, and we got home at 4:38, and I ran in, had a shower. I'd showered this morning, obviously, but like when you've been driving, you've been to a city, you just feel a bit. So had a shower, washed my hair, and still managed to get to, we got to rural classes early, actually. I think they were quite surprised. So videos to follow that will hopefully now make sense. I meant to film at the airport, but it was a bit of a mad dash. So we've just dropped Betsy off and Finn for their holiday to Cyprus. And Mike took a day's leave because we thought we'd take them to the airport and then stop off on the way home. Sort of Rye or Tenterton or somewhere. And I was approaching Gatwick. Straight over? I was approaching Gatwick.
At the roundabout, take the first exit onto Airport Road.
And I thought, I saw the signs for Brighton. And we were supposed to be coming down to do a recce at the end of the month. And I thought, that's a bit daft, because it frees up time for us to do something else or actually do nothing. And I thought, do you know what? Some of you are recuperating.
At the roundabout, take the second exit to Merck.
Recuperating or bored of the football. Right. Let's do Brighton today and do you a video. So Betsy and Finn literally literally 2 minutes ago, dropped off. So we are going to go to Brighton and do a recce and go home the coastal route, because I've got to be back obviously for rural at 5:15. So let's hope we have a nice adventure and find a nice spot for our flash mob. We're sort of in Brighton. There's a big park there. Oh, everyone's just gone dizzy. I think it's called Preston Park, but that looks a bit boring, doesn't it? But we want lots of people. So we're heading down to the marina. Looks like we're coming up to the seafront.
At the roundabout, woo-hoo! Take the second exit onto Madeira Drive, then arrive at your destination.
Brighton Pier. Get the elders on the helter skelter at the end, that'd be good. See the old pier look? I mean, I'm spoiling it for you, Rick. Can you hear me? I'm spoiling it for you, really, because I'm going to see it all. Hang on, let me turn the camera around. Hold on, how can I do that? So, keep up. Sorry. No. You've got to film me talking, but you've got to keep up. Right. I'm conscious of the fact you probably can't hear me with all this blinking traffic. We should go down on the prom, really. I might go and walk along the prom. I'm going to walk. Right, there were some minor camera issues there. My cameraman needs to keep up with me and get the scenery in at the same time. What I was going to tell you, just to put it into perspective, we've paid, I think it's what, 20 quid, isn't it, to come to Brighton for the day, coach travel, have a day, you know, coach will park up and have a lovely day. To park for 2 hours has just cost us £10.10. That's half of what we've paid for a whole day, travel included. Bargain, mid lovers. Just in that seafood stall. And I don't know if I'd, you're a bit close. I don't know if I'd like to eat seafood anymore from one of those places with a, that lobster just went to my mouth. I've seen a couple of seafood stalls, but what I mean is, just with the sea being in the state it is, I just don't know that I'd fancy eating it anymore. I used to love a nice cockle, my life movers. That really is an example of the old and the new together, isn't it? You've got the old here. And I don't know what that's called, is it the Brighton Eye? I love that. So, like London, I really like seeing the old with the new. I mean, it's a bit sad that that's the burnt out old pier, but. Yeah, this should be good. Midlife movers. Look, bring a ball. We can have a game of netball. That's probably basketball nets, but we can have a game of netball, can't we? With that nice background. And see, Pump. Right, I think. But I was going to film this. If you look here, look, there's old parts of the old burnt here. I think this is probably bits of it. And I thought, oh, I mean, we haven't explored yet, because the pier's in that direction. We're going up to look at the bandstand, but I thought, look. How about that? And next to it, look. There's this square. We've got
this. Why did that midlife movie? If we were there, sorted our stuff and spilt. You've got the people, look,
up there in the Brighton, whatever it's called, 360, is it?
They could have a show as well, couldn't they?
It's right, so you've got
360 there, that place I showed you the other side, and then look, this place.
Yet.
Paddling pool for the little ones. Oh, and the pigeon. That's a shame. How gorgeous. I think I've found the bandstand. Looks a bit small with last notice.
Turn your phone off a minute. You can just... Okay. So, basically, you can just access it. So, if on the day, like me, you thought, oh, it's going to go up, and if it's not a band playing, of course, put my big toe on, do a bit of George Travolta, you can. There you go. Easy access. Come on. I mean, I'm a man of this.
His flag up for prom. Anyway, it's Brighton, I suppose. You've even got the prom. You know, if all else failed, we'll just stop the traffic, do it on the prom. But we haven't actually been down and up to the pier yet, so. I haven't been here for, I don't know, about 7 years, and really that was a whistle stop tour. It was when Chalky Walky Doodah was open, and we came and did that, and it was quite cold, I seem to remember. But it's really lovely, there's all these little shops. And I like looking at old things, so like that, which we missed on this whistle stop tour, would have been the entrance to the old pier, that lovely tiled bit. Lovely. The Grand Hotel. Just behind those bins, behind that fence, is a massive sandpit as well for the children, because of course it's a stony beach. It's just lovely. It's really warm. It doesn't look sunny, but it's warm. There he is, the chief cameraman, chief bag holder, coat holder.
Importantly, I've just found the public loos. So we've been done a lot of filming, haven't we, by the old pier and the eye. So right on the prom, there's this set of loos. If I don't find any more, there's those. They look nice and clean, they're fine. That's just reminded me, do you remember when we did that recce of Hyde Park and those loos, I couldn't even go in. Oh god, they stunk. Well, I've just had to have a wee. Yeah, they're fine. Cleaned regularly, there's a bloke sat on his phone waiting to clean behind you once you've been in. Not literally. What I mean is, there's someone in attendance all the time. They were clean, weren't they?
Yep.
Yeah, they were alright. Good find.
For those of you that know, the battle bar. I bet some of you would love that. Well, let's not tell Mike there's live sports with that bloody football. I was going to tell you, hang on.
Marion at Ramsgate, keep up with me. Marion at Ramsgate remembered last night. So, I can't stand football. And of course, Mike loves it. And I've got no issue with that. So, when it's the big tournaments, like World Cup, Euros, years and years ago, and I might have bored you with this before, but years and years ago, he came up with this idea
that he would do like a Euros menu or a World Cup menu. So for example, now it's the Euros, so he does a Euros menu once or twice a day, depending on the country, sometimes a bit. So it's like just one thing that he carefully picks. He cooks something from that country, and this is supposed to pique my interest. So he's done some cheeky little bits so far, I've got to say. Last night, Sunday was a bit of a cheat. He had a Danish beer, then he had a French beer. I thought you did. What was it?
Danish.
Yeah.
France played last night, not Sunday.
Wow, done, mate. He nearly went over that wall. But you had a French beer, didn't you?
Yeah, but that was just a drink.
Oh, I don't count. So we had a Danish beer because Denmark. And as you know, I spoiled him. So I did him roast lamb and all the trimmings. I don't eat lamb, so we had pork. Anyway, it was tasty. And last night was my favourite. He did, it was fun. Get away. There's that lobster that pinched my bum. Oh, I think I'm funny. It was a French dish, and it was a piece that should have been lemon sole, but I was in Canterbury getting Betsy's last minute things yesterday, and Marx's didn't have any lemon sole. Anyway, and I couldn't get to deal to get to fishmongers. Anyway, piece of cod with prawns, pommes frites, chips, in a caper and
brown butter sauce, capers and lemon and parsley.
And I even bought some cheeky samphire to put on the top. That was delish. And for pudding, coconut French toast. You know when you do your French toast when you're camping, we do anyway, fry off your French toast with a bit of bacon. Well, this was dessert, so it was brioche bread coated in vanilla and egg, and then dunked in desiccated coconut, fried in butter, served with like roasted pineapple with maple
spiced
syrup.
Oh, all spice,
sorry,
on
I keep
it.
Getting it wrong.
Spiced roasted pineapple.
So it was lovely. So I did turn up at Ramsgate. Mind those
I'm
things.
Here, I'm
so it was delicious. What's today?
Today it's Czech Republic. No, it's good. It's
is
good.
It?
Yeah.
What is it? Mind that
I'm
thing.
I'm not telling you.
Oh, I'll let you know one way or the other what we've got today. Anyway, we've now reached the fun fair. I love the gallopers. Hang on. Oh, I can't get over the thing. I adore the gallopers. Anyway, speak in a minute. This whistle stopped horse. Too close, that's close enough. For those of you that get a little bit thirsty on our outings, there are loads of places to get a little drink if you're a bit parched.
I'm quite thirsty now.
Ah, make sure. Another one, look. Another one, loads of places. And that's just on the seafront. Right, Mike's just said to me, why are your eyebrows crispy? And I went, oh, because Betsy, before we took her to the airport, she wanted to jello. They look grey, do they? Right, I'm rubbing that out. Anyway, this, it's not even retro. It's more Victorian, isn't it? This, Midlife Losers, is my idea of heaven. Old fashioned here. There's not old fashioned music at the moment. As a kid, we had the days out in Margate. I think I've told you before. It was all about the seaside. And I just love all this. It can't be too cheesy. If there'd been a store with a Kiss Me Quick app, it would have been on my head. They're probably not allowed to have Kiss Me Quick, Squeeze Me Slow apps anymore, are they? I might have to get something printed and have what I'm doing. I might do that for Carnival Midlife Movers. There's an idea. Get my printers to do me. I'm doing that. Anyway, look at that. Look at that. What is not
look, the old kiosk. I remember as a kid, I'm sure you could see the sea.
Yeah, you could.
Through the bottom of Deal Pier. No, not just the end. Oh. Anyway, the end of the pier, we haven't got time to do that because we've got, like I said, we put 2 hours on the car, great expense, and we've got to leave because, I forgot, because of rule. Not because of, but we've got time, and I want to get to the lanes because I love the lanes. And also, little secret, I've got a thing about post boxes and I've got a thing about Lidos as well, so I'm hoping on the way out, if I do the coastal road, I'll see the Brighton and Hove Lido, which they closed down, but I think they've opened it up again. Anyway, I'm waffling on. Let's go to the lanes. So, we've come into Brighton City to find...
Sorry.
Or to visit the lanes. Like I say, I love this place. We've only probably got about half an hour here. It's far too narrow for our needs. But I don't know how old they are, but you can. It's just picture it at Christmas, you know, with snow and the lamps. It's I like just incredible. I like getting to the bit where they
love that one.
The junk shops. But you could just spend all, I'd like to spend all day here. Which way am I going? Oh, I think that used to be
Chucky Wucky Doodles, yeah.
And now we're here, I wish I hadn't had the bright idea, to be honest, of saying we'll do a whistle stop tour because it's such a great place. I think that, isn't that such a shame it ever closed. I think it closed just before COVID.
I think it was that.
Yeah. Anyway, I'm going to try and find a little chair. We're about to walk through the lanes, and this is still part of it. This is my kind of Brighton. Just walk past shops where the shoes are unusual. There's a really old tobacconist, you can still buy the tools to cut the end of a cigar. Fabric shops, have a look at the a bit like Camden, the leg with the shoe, and further up there's a sale. Just lively, spice shop, kiddie shop. Just oh la shoe DM it's just wonderful and I can't wait until I get to the bit we're gonna run out of time I know we are we're gonna be running back to the car where there's like all the thrift shops and the junk shops but this is just I could just sit right there all day and watch it all happen. Buffet shop, you know. Do you want a buffet? Come to Brighton. Poor bloke on the side that's just had the biggest seagull crap. It's a poor bloke. He's got to go back to work. Look, body piercing.
Turn left onto North Road.
I just did a lovely thrift shop, but I was too busy. That poor bloke. I haven't got any wipes, otherwise I'd have offered him a wipe. Anyway, come on.
Taking a video, darling.
To get in at Andover, and then I'll move out there.
Walk into the centre.
The one by the post office on the
bridge. Spanners that way, but yeah. What about this, midlife neighbours? This with the grandchildren.
Stick it in the sports bar.
Do you think Mike would mind? I don't know where to look, I haven't got time. But you could pick up some
Thames here. It's gorgeous, isn't it? We're out of breath, we're sweating. So we went through the little lanes, lots of jewellery shops, loads of jewellery shops. Then come out like the big laney lanes, and they're more vibrant actually at the weekends because they've got all the markets out. But I wanted to quickly, before we end this, the Brighton bit tour, I wanted to show you this building. And fantastic. I think I'll have to get a photo next to this, don't you? Yeah.
Aren't they cute? Still
in Brighton. Yes. Right, Midlife Movers, that was the Brighton bit done. I think that was really successful. We're sweating. I hope you enjoyed it. I'm going to try and show you the Lido on the way out. Hope you enjoyed it. And for all you football widows, hope that just gives you, I don't know how long it's going to be, knowing me, about 15 minutes, I don't know. But we got back with 3 minutes to spare on the car. I don't know how we did it, but good fun. A real jam-packed 2 hours, and I feel satisfied. There's so many places we can do it. I know, sort of, if the coach driver said, where should I drop you, I sort of know where to say. We can't go wrong. A really good job done. It's going to be a brilliant day. It's incredible to think
speed cover ahead.
Literally been driving for a minute and all that wonderful hustle and bustle and Victorian seaside place, it's just green. We've just driven past, I wish I'd have shown you, Rodine School, which is
at
a really
roundabout, take the second exit onto Marine Drive.
Really famous private school. It just looked, it was huge, it was vast, it looked even bigger than Hogwarts. But yeah, a stark contrast. And I wonder, you know, before, I'm pretending about my history really, because somebody's going to go, that's
in
not right. But
turn left onto Park Road.
It makes you wonder if that's what, this is what Brighton Seafront was like before all those wonderful buildings were built. Who knows? But look, it's just completely different. It's interesting, isn't it?
It's a little video for Carol, look. Look at these beauties. Carol's a mover with little, are they called Frenchies? What are these ones called?
Yeah, French Bulldogs.
Yeah.
No, jump in.
Are they?
So mum and two pups.
Oh, which one's mum?
So this is mum.
There's mum.
That's Betty. The pups, Bruce.
Betty and Bruce.
And Bella.
Oh.
She had four. I was allowed to keep two. So.
Oh, perfect. Thank you.
That's all right.
Midlife Movers, I cannot begin to tell you how excited I am about being here. Right. We don't know where we're going. Look at this lovely curved. I'm going to get a really good photo of the outside of it for you. I'm going to say it's Art Deco. I just want to put my feet in that water. They're going to do it. They're going to come and trespass it in a minute. We went in the wrong entrance. Look at the curvature of this building. Right when you see the other side. Oh God, have I got to walk over their plants now? Come on, you dick. Am I ever going to be back for class? Yes, I will, I promise. Look. I'm here. I have made it.
I'm not allowed to put my feet in the water midlife movies. Look at this building.
Look.
Just look. Think of all that. I always think back to years gone by when, you know, and even now, hopefully, it gets busy. But like all the families that were here having fun. I'm allowed to go and have my photo taken by the fountain. I'm not allowed to put my feet in. I can put my hand in. But it's a bit of a seasonal thing, and I didn't quite understand what she said, but I'm not going to break the rules. Oh, I wish I could just get my sweaty feet that have been trudging around Brighton in that water. It would be so nice. Just look, honestly, look. It is so beautiful. I know we've got the paddle. We have got the paddling pool. I'm reliably informed it's 24 degrees. I know you. A lot of you think I'm a nutter, and you probably really do now. But I'm certain things are just a sucker for nostalgia. It gives me a funny feeling. And I honestly think it comes from the way I was brought up and the things I experienced as a child. And this sort of thing just takes me back. You know, the window, the bit, just everything about it is just wonderful. Right. I've got a souvenir. I did buy something. Actually, I bought a strawberry moisturiser with Brighton as well. I feel happy about that. It's just... The reason I couldn't put my feet in is because she didn't want to charge me £11 for the session for me to put my feet in. Bless her heart, should I feel mean? I thought, well, just let me put my feet in. Anyway, off to rural. Wish me luck, I'll let you know what time we got back.